Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In this video, I will be trying to describe my understanding about quantum mechanics. Quantum mechanics is very much required to understand quantum computing. And today we have reached in a stage where machine learning and cloud computing are everywhere. But the next big thing is quantum computing. So what is quantum computing? To understand quantum computing, you have to understand how digital computer works. In this video, I am not going to describe about digital computing because there are many textbooks, videos, everything there. So, and already those are taught in college. So I'm not going to describe those things, but I will focus mostly on the difference between digital computing and quantum computing. Digital computer use listened that digital computer uses zeros and ones. Means, for example, the smallest piece in digital computing is bit kind of thing. So a bit can have two state, either zero or one. Okay. So a bit can be in two state, either zero or one. So when we actually arrange a set of bits, we came up with byte. So a combination of 8-bit is a byte. Any bit can be in 0 or 1. Any bit can be 0 or 1, right? So suppose we have a combination like this one. So it is actually equivalent to 5 in our decimal number system. So there is mathematical solutions how we can convert from binary to digital, digital to binaries. Those are taught in digital electronics. I am not going to cover here. So what is the difference, major difference between digital computing and quantum computing? In quantum computing, we have something called qubit. The difference between bit and qubit is it has three state, like it may be 0, may be 1, or may be a mix of A and B, and both are possible simultaneously, which is not very easily understandable in common sense, but we have lots of other videos you can watch on the YouTube, and I can give some links in the comment section also. But again, so we can again make a combination of those qubits to make a byte of quantum computing. So each may have different combination. So as we make all of them 0 or 1 simultaneously here, okay, if we make all them to be in superposition state. So superposition state is a state where it is both 0 and 1. So when this byte, all bits are set to 1, it represents a number 255. So total 255 combinations can be achieved using 8 bits. Here with 8 qubits, we have all the possible combinations at a time simultaneously. Okay, now this is called superposition, where two states can be at the same time. Another principle of quantum computing is entanglement. To understand entanglement here, for example, we have to understand a system of two qubits. So suppose these two qubits are there, which are not entangled. So when they are not entangled, so if you change the state of anyone, the other does not get affected. Okay, it is independent of this. On the other hand, if these two qubits are entangled, it means if we change the state of one or collapse the state of one, the other gets immediately changed, and it is always opposite kind of thing. If it is in a superposition state, the other will also in a superposition state. So if we move the object in a distance. So still this entanglement works. So the physical distance in 3D space does not account for this entanglement. But how this information is passed from one qubit to another is still mysterious to all the scientists, including Albert Einstein. So in this video, I have tried to show you basics of quantum computing. I know I have used AutoCAD and people use it for drafting, but I normally don't use AutoCAD for drafting nowadays. Well, to understand quantum mechanics in full detail, there are good websites. In Code Project, there is a good article with four parts. I have also started understanding from that. There are many other things also. So if you want to understand in detail, you can go through this. For this, you have to understand matrix, complex numbers, all these things. And finally come with the visualization of these states using Bloch sphere. So Bloch sphere is a kind of 3D sphere with multiple axes. So I think using AutoCAD also, I can visualize this Bloch sphere. So I think I can continue this demonstration of Bloch sphere and how it's actually operates in another video. But to understand Bloch sphere, you have to understand rotation matrix, and as in digital circuit, we have to understand digital gates, we have to understand quantum gates. To understand quantum gates, you have to understand rotation matrix about a specific axis kind of thing. So again, I see a good relationship between this CAD knowledge and this quantum mechanics. Let's see how I can move ahead with this. So I am stopping here. If I make another video, probably I will try to demonstrate how Bloch sphere can help us to understand the quantum states. Okay, thank you.